Hey guys, Ravi here, and this is an ESP32. It's a pretty versatile microcontroller and comes with the support for Bluetooth Low Energy or BLE. BLE is very popular with stuff like heart rate monitors, temperature and humidity sensors, and anything else that needs to communicate in small bursts of data infrequently over short distances. Why you would wanna use it for your project instead of something like Wi-Fi is because you can use BLE to communicate with most modern smartphones. It doesn't require you to set up a web server, you don't need to connect to a separate network, and since BLE is for Bluetooth Low Energy, it's more favorable for portable battery-powered projects. You know what else is more favorable? Buying electronic components from this video sponsor, LCSC.com. LCSC distributes over 200,000 products ranging from semiconductors to resistors, capacitors, diodes, inductors, connectors, and sensors. Its catalog is also integrated with Easy EDA, so you can order the exact component that you need for your PCB design. Click the link in the description to get $8 off on your first order. Now, I made a similar video almost a year ago about this very topic, but that was before proper libraries for BLE for the ESP32 Arduino core had come out. The method that I showed there was really jank and was basically just a workaround. But now that the libraries are out, I'm going to show you how to properly use BLE with the ESP32. Now, we are gonna go about this in a bit of a reverse order. First, I'm gonna show you an example and how you can implement it. And then I am going to teach you what you need to know to use BLE for your own projects. The first example we are going to look at is to transmit just a number, that number being the value of a potentiometer. The connections are as simple as they could be. The first pin to 3.3 volt, second pin to GPIO 36, and the last pin to ground. The code is where it gets a bit complicated. I'll explain things in more detail further in the video. But for now, all you need to know is that the code under setup configures and starts the BLE server, and these two lines are what send the value over BLE. Once the code has been uploaded, you can open the NRF Connect app on your smartphone. Click scan and you'll see my ESP32 listed. Tap connect and you'll see three services. Tap unknown service and click the three downward pointing arrow besides the unknown characteristic. You should now be seeing a value, and turning the potentiometer should also change the values accordingly. Now, to actually understand what's going on here, you need to first know a little bit about how BLE works. There is a specific hierarchy that you need to conform to in order to properly use BLE. There is a BLE device. That device runs a BLE server. That server provides some specific services. Those services have some characteristics, and each characteristic has some properties. Now, I know that this may sound a bit complicated, but it would become simpler once you understand the first example. Let's start from the top and work our way down. First of all, we need to initialize our device. Whatever name you give the device here will be the name that appears while scanning. Then we need to configure the BLE server, which is done by these two lines. The first one basically sets everything up, while in the second one we are supplying the function that determines what action to take whenever different BLE events happen, like what to do when a connection is established or when some data is received. We aren't receiving any data in this example, so ignore it for now. Next, we configure a service by supplying a unique ID to it. This ID tells the receiver what kind of data it is receiving. Different IDs represent different types of services for different use cases. In this example, we are just using a random ID, hence it shows up as an unknown service. Similarly, we supply another random ID to configure the characteristic. This ID tells the receiver what this particular characteristic is. For example, the heart rate service would obviously have the heart rate measurement characteristic, but it also might have the body sensor location characteristic, which would tell the receiver from where the heart rate is being measured. While configuring a characteristic along with the ID, we also set its properties. These properties determine what the receiver can do. The most common and obvious one is read. The receiver can read the data being supplied by the characteristic. The write property allows the client to send some data back to the server. The notify property works like a messaging app. Whenever there is a change in the data of the server, it notifies the client and the value automatically gets updated. The indicate property is identical to the notify, but here the client just lets the server know that it has read the change by sending an acknowledgement. In this example, we are using the read and notify property so that any change in the value of the potentiometer is automatically reflected on the receiver's end. Next, we add descriptors. Descriptors are optional hints that you can attach to characteristics to give a user a little extra information like the range of a temperature sensor. If you are using the notify property, which we are, you must add this BLE2902 descriptor. It just keeps note of whether the notifications are enabled or not. A Ble server can broadcast data to all the devices around it, letting them know of its name and other related information. A client uses this information to determine whether it wants to connect to it or not. The device is essentially advertising itself. So we need to configure this advertising in this line, then start the service and finally start the server. Now in the main loop, we wait until the device is connected to a client and then set our value and then notify the client. Here, the 1 signifies the number of bytes we are sending. The maximum value of our potentiometer in this example is limited to 255, which incidentally is also the maximum value a single byte can store. One very important thing to note here is that the setValue function can only send unsigned 8-bit integers, which is equivalent to a single character or char. Before sending any data, you always need to convert it into this format and then convert it back on the client side. That was a very basic example of how to use Ble with the ESP32 Arduino core. Let's do a bit more of an advanced application. We'll make a Ble thermometer. I'm using the DS18B20 temperature sensor along with the Fire Beetle ESP32 board. Link to both of which will be in the description below. The connections are exactly the same. VCC to 3.3 volt, ground to ground, and data pin to GPIO36. The code also isn't much different, but there are a few key points that you'll need to take note of. This function is just to retrieve the temperature using the one wire protocol. The first significant change concerning Ble is with the unique IDs that we assigned earlier. These are called UUIDs, and they stand for Universally Unique Identifiers. As I hinted earlier, there are some predefined UUIDs that have been assigned to certain Ble services and characteristics. These predefined profiles are called GET profiles and they basically specify the format of data being transferred along with what is being transferred. You can find all the officially recognized GET profiles on Bluetooth.com website, which I would link in the description below. In our example, the ID 081A is for environmental sensing service, while the ID 2A6E is for the temperature characteristic. And the NRF Connect app automatically detects these services for what they are because of the UUIDs that we used. Now, to send the data, we have to be a bit careful. The GET profile specifies that the data must be in the format of a single 16-bit integer and for good reason. Our temperature can be anywhere from 2 to 6 characters long. Such large data can't be stored by an 8-bit integer, but we can only send 8-bit integers. So to work around this, we store our data in a 16-bit integer and cast it to an 8-bit integer before sending and specify the length to be 2 bytes. Also, you might have noticed that I have multiplied the temperature by 100. This is because the client expects an integer and not a float. The client would divide it by 100 on its end before serving the data. And there you go, you have your very own Ble thermometer. Using the same concept, you can make your own heart rate monitor, a step counter, a proximity sensor, and more. But what if you want to do something different, something that is not defined by the GET profiles? Well, that is exactly what we did in our first example. By using random UUIDs, we basically made our own custom profile. Also, you are not limited to sending an integer. You can also send strings. As a demonstration, let's take a look at another example. We'll make a status display for a switch. Again, most of the base code is the same. I've selected 1700 as the service ID and 1A00 as the characteristic ID. There are two ways of sending text, by putting the text in quotation marks in the setValue function, or you can pass the address of a character array. Just remember to cast it into a char first. This example demonstrates both methods. You are free to explore and mess around with all these examples on your own. The app that I am using to display this is a custom app I made in MIT App Inventor. The app can only display strings. Link to download this and all the example codes that I have shown would be in the description below. Now, I would recommend that if you are using a custom profile, then convert all your data into a char array and transmit that. It's a lot easier to deal with. I have included an example below which shows how to convert different types of data formats into a char array for your convenience. Now the only thing left is to utilize the write function. This is easy enough. Just declare a function in this format. Whenever some data is received, this function would run and the received data would be available in a char array value. Do with this data as you please. I hope that you learned something new. Let me know in the comments below about any Ble project that you make. Leave a like if these videos were helpful, and I'll see you guys in the next one.